In this video, we will talk about how to solve the dual linear programming problem directly using the dual simplex method. In the previous videos, we talked about how to solve the dual if we already know the optimal solution to the primal. We can use three methods. Method 1, we can use this formula to calculate the optimal solution to the dual. Method 2, we can identify the optimal solution to the dual by observing the optimal primal tableau. Method 3, we can use complementary slackness to find the optimal solution to the dual. What if we don't know the optimal solution to the primal? In that case, we cannot use these three methods. We can use another method called the dual simplex method to directly solve the dual problem in the standard form. The dual simplex method has three steps. In step 1, we need to reformulate the dual problem so it will be a maximization problem with non-negative root 0 and non-positive right-hand side, RHS. In step 2, we need to choose the most negative basic variable as a living variable, and the rule will be the pivot rule. Then compute the ratio for each non-basic variable that has a negative coefficient in the pivot rule. The ratio is the coefficient of a non-basic variable in row 0 over the coefficient of the non-basic variable in the pivot rule. After that, we choose the variable with the smallest absolute ratio as the entering variable. We use elementary rule operations, or EROs, to make the entering variable a basic variable in the pivot rule. In the dual simplex method, we determine the living variable first, then the entering variable, which is quite different from the regular or primal simplex method. In step 3, if there is any constraint with the negative right-hand side, and each variable has a non-negative coefficient, then the dual linear programming problem is infeasible. If the right-hand side of each constraint is non-negative, then an optimal solution is found, and stop. Otherwise, return to step 2. Let's illustrate the dual simplex method using this example. This is a dual problem in the standard form. It's a minimization problem. All the constraints are greater than or equal to the right-hand side. All the variables are greater than or equal to 0. The first step of the dual simplex method is to reformulate the dual problem. We change this problem to a maximization problem by taking the opposite of the objective function and give it to v. In the canonical form, each variable has a non-negative coefficient in row 0. We need to introduce two excess variables, e1 and e2, to make these two equality constraints. Now the right-hand side of both constraints positive. We need to make them non-positive by multiplying negative 1 for both sides. This is the updated canonical form. Let's write this in the Tableau. Now let's find the basic variables. They are the variables with the coefficient 1 and appear in only one row and not other rows. So the basic variables are e1 and e2. Remember, v is not a basic variable. It represents the objective function value, but by convention we just put it in this column. All other variables are non-basic variables. Let's set the non-basic variables to 0 and solve for the basic variables. This is what we get. Now we need to check if this tableau is optimal or not by checking if the right-hand side of each constraint is non-negative. We find that the right-hand side both constraints are negative, so it's not optimal yet. We need to choose the most negative basic variable as the living variable, which is e2, and this row will be the pivot row. Let's compute the ratio for each non-basic variable that has a negative coefficient in the pivot row. The ratio is the coefficient of a non-basic variable in row 0 over the coefficient of that non-basic variable in the pivot row. 1 divided by negative 2 is negative 1 over 2. 2 divided by negative 1 is negative 2. After that, we choose the variable with the smallest absolute ratio as the entering variable, which is U1. We use EROs to make this entering variable have a coefficient 1 as a pivot row and make it disappear in all other rows. This is the new Tableau. Let's solve for the basic variables. They are U1 and U1. Now we need to check if the Tableau is optimal or not by checking if the right-hand side of each constraint is non-negative. We find that the right-hand side of this constraint is still negative, so it's not optimal yet. We need to choose the most negative basic variable as the living variable, which is U1, and this row will be the pivot row. Let's compute the ratio for each non-basic variable that has a negative coefficient in the pivot row. The ratio is the coefficient of a non-basic variable in row 0 over the coefficient of that non-basic variable in the pivot row. 1 over 2 divided by negative 3 over 2 is negative 1 over 3. 1 over 2 divided by negative 1 over 2 is negative 1. After that, we choose a variable with the smallest absolute ratio as the entering variable, which is U3. We use EROs to make this entering variable have a coefficient 1 in the pivot row and make it disappear in all other rows. This is a new Tableau. Now let's solve for the basic variables. They are U3 and U1. Now we need to check if this Tableau is optimal or not by checking if the right-hand side of each constraint is non-negative. They are both positive, so this Tableau is optimal. The optimal solution to the dual problem is W is equal to negative V is equal to 10 over 3. U1 is equal to 10 over 3. U3 is equal to 2 over 3. U2, U1, and E2 are 0. Now we know that each linear programming problem can be formulated from two perspectives, primal and dual. We can solve the primal using the primal simplex method, and solve the dual using the dual simplex method. The question is, when should we solve the primal and when should we solve the dual? For linear programming problem, if the number of the basic variables is much smaller than the number of constraints, the problem is highly likely to degenerate. Therefore, the answer to the question is, if the primal is degenerate, it's better to solve the dual problem, and vice versa. Okay, thanks for watching.